Now, a Bristol University student who struggled with anorexia in his teens is trying to get more young men talking about the illness and tackle perceptions that it only affects women.
Well, men make up around 10% of cases, but Ed Southgate believes more are going under the radar, and he's now working with the campaign group Fixers to change that.
I'd hide food to make people think I'd eaten it. I would lie about what I'd eaten. I'd wear certain clothes to hide the fact I was getting skinnier. My name's Ed Southgate, I'm 20 and I live in Bristol. My Fixers project is aimed at breaking down the stereotypes around anorexia, just to show that it's not just a woman's illness and that men do significantly get it as well. When I was 15, things just felt massively out of control in terms of friendship groups, schoolwork, family, and that's when I started to develop anorexia. I just gradually started to reduce what I ate. Everyone always associates this illness with wanting to be thin, but for me it wasn't anything about that. I didn't care about how I looked, I didn't care how thin I was. It was all about just having something to control. So I became obsessed with calories. You could pretty much just name a food and I'll be able to give you the calorie content of it. It started to spiral into this almost like addiction of restriction. So I would hide the fact that I'm not eating, I'd cook loads for my family. I went downhill quite quickly. You could see all of my bones and all that kind of stuff, but it didn't faze me. Like, my whole outlook was completely warped by this obsession with control that I couldn't see how unhealthy I was being. Eventually, my body got so weak, it collapsed, and then that's when the doctors got involved and they realised it was serious. And that's when my recovery stages started.
Some research by Beat recently found that typically men and boys are waiting twice as long as girls and women to receive appropriate care for eating disorders. Men do get overlooked, and a lot of it is to do to a lack of understanding amongst GPs, in that the stereotype is something that only affects women and girls.
As part of my project, I got together with a group of guys at uni to talk about the issue of men and anorexia.
So I think we're seeing these issues becoming sort of coming more into the fray as we begin to sort of, the stigmas of them are sort of broken down.
I'm definitely much more aware of like girls that have eating disorders rather than boys, because it's just they feel open to talk.
Whilst going through recovery, did you meet any other guys with anorexia?
The doctor who I was working with told me about other guys that she'd worked with, but I never actually met anyone else with it. I guess I felt a sense of shame that I was I was the one guy who had managed to get this woman's illness. So I guess, yeah, if there were more guys open about their experiences and ready to talk about it, it would have helped a lot. I think I was able to recover because of how strict my parents were in sticking to the medical advice that they had been given on how to deal with me. Having an actual secure group of friends here who I know that we all get on really well and I know that we all care about each other, all of those things have just made me not think twice about food. From my project, I just hope that I've shed some light on the issue of anorexia, and I want people to realise that men do suffer from this illness as well as women.
And as you can see, Ed has joined us live in the studio along with Sarah Palmer from Somerset and Wessex Eating Disorders Association. Thanks to both of you very much for coming in. Ed, a really powerful report there. That's the first time you've seen it, actually.
Yeah.
What made you speak out about it?
I think it's because, like I say in the film, there is this perception that it's an illness which just affects women. And alongside that, there's a perception that it's all about body image and wanting to be thin, when for me, it was nothing about that. When I was at school, I felt really insecure. I didn't have a secure group of friends, so I didn't feel like I had any control in my life. So food was the one thing I could control, and that's what caused it. And I think that's what the message I want to give is that men get it, and it's not just about body image, it's about controlling something.
Yeah. Sarah, you're nodding along to everything that Ed is saying there. Is that something you're increasingly seeing? Are you seeing more men come forward?
Yes. Definitely. And I think in the last 10 to 15 years, there has been a great increase in the number of young men suffering from eating disorders, all types of eating disorders and anorexia too.
Is there a bit of a lack of understanding, both of you, do you think, from GPs who are probably looking out for this in women?
I think there probably is. because I think like the doctors didn't properly get involved with me until I was pretty much on death's door. They said I had like 3 weeks to live or something like that, and that's when they started taking it seriously. They were like, oh, maybe this guy does have an eating disorder. This is when I got officially diagnosed, even though my parents had taken me to the GP many times before. He was just said stuff like, parents just watch what he eats and try, and it might just be a growth spurt. So I think there is a culture where we're looking for something that it's not.
So what do we do, Sarah, to make sure this looks out for?
Yes, I think I agree in that lots of GPs, male anorexia sufferers have very different set of symptoms to females. Mm. And I think GPs are quite aware of all the female symptoms, but actually there's a specific group that is specific to male eating disorder sufferers, and that there's a little bit of education around that as well. Yeah, I'd agree with you, Ed, there.
Well, amazing. I mean, you know, I think, Ed, that your story has made such a difference to people and people's eyes. So thank you so much to both of you for coming.
Thank you.
Well, if you need any help or advice on this subject, then do head to our website. There is some details of organisations that you can get in touch with. Both Ed and Sarah are going to be live in a few minutes' time on our Facebook page. They'll be able to help you with any questions that you may have. So do go onto our Facebook page in the next few minutes if you can.
Thank you.